We don't expect to solve all the problems that are so embedded in so many of the cultures and societies that we visit, but we do believe that we can make a difference with individual people.
My daughter Isabel, who's the youngest, befriended Zoe Villalobos, who is the third daughter of the pastor of the Church of Brasileto. And one afternoon, my daughter asked if Zoe could come back to the hotel with her and some friends and actually clean up to go back to the church to have dinner. And so Zoe went with my daughter, and as we got back to the church that night, Zoe ran to her mother and said, "Mother, mother, look at my hair." Said that Isabel washed my hair with shampoo and cream rinsed it twice. And that's the first time she'd ever had shampoo in her hair.
It's so incredible to meet people like we did when we went to Malawi. One woman that looked at me and said, "You know, I have five children, my husband has left me, one of my children has died." And then she looked at me and she says, "You know, I'm so blessed. My faith in God, it has blessed me so much. He's blessed me." And I just looked at her and I just thought, you know, you have so little in things, but you're so grand in your faith.
At one of the well dedications, we had just started a well near an existing water supply, which was basically a mud hole. And when we started the pump, an elderly lady came over and started looking at the water coming out of the pump. And she just seemed to be frozen there. And I asked the field officer, I said, "Is there something wrong with her?" And he said, "No, she has never seen clear water. She did not know water was clear." And at that moment, I just said, how often we just take things like that for granted here in the U.S., where people around the world, much less fortunate than us, consider that as a luxury. So that was a profound moment for me that we are so blessed here, and there is so much we can give, although, you know, to us it may seem very simple.
This little girl in Jamaica, her name was Janice. And Janice is a strong, vibrant little girl, and she looked so much like a girl that we would see running around this church. And yet she lives in an orphanage in Kingston, Jamaica. She's pretty much on her own. I think about Janice every day, and I pray for her every day, multiple times, just when she's on my heart. I sort of just lift up a prayer because I know she's going about her day. She's down there playing, having fun, doing her thing. But I also know that the weeks when adults and kids come to visit and come to be with her are when those are the times that she really gets to be loved on and hugged and watched and rooted for, and I know that those are really special moments, and so I hope someone's down there playing with her right now.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like
Even if you only touch a few people or a small community with what you do, it is a start. And I think that's the impact that we're looking for. It's not to change the world in one trip. It's just to do what we're capable of doing and using our talents and resources in the best way to further Christ's kingdom.
How sweet the sound.